In this lecture, we are going to cover the types of resistor. So, if we talk about resistor, the resistor's works in electronic circuit is to oppose or resist the flow of current. So, hence they are named as resistor. So, resistor is measured in units called ohm. So, if we classify resistors, they are categorized into two types. First is fixed resistor and second is variable resistor. So, fixed resistor is the one for which the value of its resistance is specified or fixed and cannot be varied in general. But in case of variable resistor, we can change its value. So if you talk about fixed resistor, first one is carbon fill resistor, which is generally used in electronic circuits. So their resistive element is manufactured from the mixture of finely ground carbon or graphite and non-conductive ceramic powder to bind it all together. The mixture is molded into a cylindrical shape with a metal bias or lead attached to each end to provide electrical connection. So then finally it is coated with an outer insulating material and color coding marking is denoted its resistive value. So the main disadvantage of using carbon fill resistors is that they tend to be very electrical noisy and having their wider range of tolerance. Typically it is of ±5%. Another type of fixed resistor is metal film resistor. So the value of resistance is controlled firstly by the thickness of the coating layer, also by fine spiral groove. Cut the road using a laser or diamond cutter. Cut the carbon or metal coating tactically into a long strip which forms the resistor. So metal film resistor can be obtained in a wider range of resistance value from few ohms to 10 of millions of ohms with a very small tolerance. For example, the typical value might be 100 kilo ohm ±1% or less. Another type of resistor is called wire wound resistor. So their resistive element are commonly length of wires, usually an alloy such as nickel, chromium, magnesium, wrapped around a small ceramic or glass fiber rod and coated in an insulating flame-proof cement film. So they are normally available in quite low value of resistance, small value like single ohms to kilo ohms, but can dissipate large amount of power. So in use, they may get very hot. So another category of resistor is variable resistor. So there are two general ways in which variable resistors are used. One is the variable resistor whose value is easily changed. The other is semi-fixed resistor that is not meant to be adjusted by anyone but a technician. So it is used to adjust the operating condition of the circuit by the technician. So the semi-fixed resistors are used to compensate for inaccuracies of the resistors and to fine-tune a circuit. The rotation angle of the variable resistor is used about 300 degrees. So some variable resistors must be turned many times to use the whole range of the resistance they offer. So this allows a very precise adjustment of their values. So these are called potentiometer or trimmer. So four center resistors at the center are semi-fixed type. Two resistors on the left are trimmer potentiometer, and this is the type of variable resistor. So there are three ways in which a variable resistor value can be changed according to its rotation angle of axis. When type A rotates clockwise, at first the resistance value changes slowly, then second half of this it changes very quickly. They are sometimes called audio taper potentiometer. Type B, rotation of the axis and the change of resistive value are directly related. The rate of change is the same or linear throughout the sweep of axis. So this type suits a resistance value adjustment in the circuit, so balanced circuit and so on. So they are sometimes called linear taper potentiometer. Type C changes exactly the opposite way to type A. As for the variable resistor, most are type A and type B. So if we talk about resistor parameters, they can be changed using variation of temperature. They are having low temperature coefficient. So temperature coefficient 50 parts per million per degree centigrade, meaning that the change in value due to the temperature changes 1 degree centigrade will not be more than 50 ohm for every 1 mega ohm of the resistor value. So the frequency response of the resistor tells us at what frequency the resistor will act as a pure resistor without any significant effect associated with these other types of frequency dependent components. So for this reason, this parameter is of the interest to the people working with the high frequency AC circuit such as RF engineers. So if we talk about carbon composition resistors, which are act as a pure resistor at the frequency in the megahertz range. Similarly, film type resistors having a spiral construction do tend to exhibit the properties of inductors, and the resistor with the worst frequency response are wire wound types, as their construction is really a coil of wires and just like a conductor. Another parameter of resistor is power dissipation. So this is a measure of amount of power that a resistor can dissipate without causing it to the overheat. So resistors are manufactured in standard power rating, and mostly these are in fraction of 1 watt. and some larger carbon and metal resistors available in 1 watt to about 5 watt. So wire wound resistors are normally available in power rating of up to 25 watt. So typical maximum temperature of carbon composition resistors would be around 100 degree to 120 degree centigrade. So for metal and oxide film types, about 150 degree centigrade. So wire wound resistor can operate at high temperature up to around 300 degree centigrade, and the minimum voltage parameter of the resistor, a few volt for some surface mount type to several thousand volts for some specialist high voltage resistor. So what next? We are covering the problem related to resistor design, the integrated circuit design of the resistor. Thank